Howdy folks, and welcome back to this Let's Play of Skyrim Special Edition. We're going to carry on from where we left off, which was of course playing as our High Elf. Game is loading, we're currently level 6, and of course my name is Sonelias. Hopefully you'll enjoy today's episode. Alright, where are we at present? We're still in the Jarl's place. So we've actually been given some access to some additional stuff. So we've been promoted to a local nobility rank. Got a few bits of stuff here, and I actually want to do some disenchanting here. I'm pretty sure I was able to change the speed of my movement here. Axe of Whiterun. Perfect. Now, I don't want to disenchant the Hooded Dalmor robes. I would love to be able to enchant an item. Dalmor boots, Dalmor gloves, and so forth. I'm going to hold off on those for the time being. There we go. We're able to run again. Which is kind of what I was aiming for. Always a good idea to be able to talk to the Jarl himself. Get some insights. Right, as you can see, I'm fairly quickly skipping through all of this and just talking to this the Jarl to basically get insight into what's happening in the alliance. But as you can see, at the moment, he's still neutral in the fight between the two key factions here. Okay. With good planning, even now, my court wizard, that we must also have. But our great. Okay. Until brave heroes step forward. Sweet. So we got some more insight. How much gold have we got at the moment? We're at 3,500. Now we need about 5,000 to be able to buy a house in town. That is, of course, my good friend Lydia. Yep, you're my house, Carl, but of course I need a house to be able to do something in there. The title of Thane is an honor, a gift for your service. Well, thank you for that, Lydia. As my Thane, I'm sworn to your service. I'll guard you and all you right. Own. I can actually have her as my companion, which I don't want at the moment. I'm pretty much, or at least pretty happy to do everything on my own for the moment being. Right. What I plan on doing at the moment, I plan on basically going to the inn. And in the inn, I'm actually planning on actually having a brief discussion with the person that's there. But before I do that, let's briefly talk to this particular priest here. Hello, my friend. Tolos was a Nord possessed of unmatched tactical skill, limitless wisdom and power, and seen into humans or man's hearts. The voice. And with it, in southern lands, he was known by the name Tiber Sept. So great. So it's basically a different name for the first emperor. Sure you can find any, because the so-called emperor is a coward. That's right. Oh yes, he agreed to banish the worship of Talos. Old Miri. And of course I'm wearing Old Miri armor, well, or robes, whatever you want to call it. Well, let me tell you something. Let them come. I have no fear. Cool. At least that shows the at least confidence of this priest here, which is good. He's quite confident in the fact that he will not be arrested, which basically is, according to him, a testament to his god's powers. This is the inn. This is the Bannered Mare. We're entering it as we speak. Alright. Let's have a brief word with these people here. The security in Whiterun is terrible. Shameful is what it is. Think you can go blade a blade with me? You'd be dead in 6 seconds. Sounds like you got a grudge. I've been talking to too hot-headed, they cried. It wasn't my fault. I told them. They wanted me to prove my worth. I guess they thought a woman was strong enough to hurt him. All right. All right. I'm not going to have a discussion with her at the moment. Anyways, I'm looking for work. Got any leads? A bounty letter at Halted Stream Camp.
I assume you it's part of the Temple of Kinnaret. People want Danica to do something about it, but people say there's someone in Riften that can change your face.
Right, always get these kind of latest gossips, because as you can see, they actually give you additional locations and additional quests on your map.
I should have guessed as much. Your kind sticks to that. You'd never think to learn from a nerd like the Jarl's wizard.
I'd like to rent a room.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
Perfect. Now let's actually have a look at what they got for sale.
Food for the hungry.
In terms of ingredients. Oh, they got salt piles. I'll buy that. Anything I want to sell them? Not really. Thank you very much for that, though. Now, I believe my room is upstairs. Ah, Michael.
If it's a lady you're looking for, you best look elsewhere. Once we Kyle.
Where'd you learn to play?
I studied there myself. Had to leave over a misunderstanding with the headmistress. I'm a bard. Trained at the Bard's College in Solitude. Carlotta put you up to this, didn't she?
All right, Carlotta.
Sorry. What did you just say? All I heard was a sound of jealousy.
All right, let's just bribe him. Let's pay him some gold.
Well, Bard does need to eat. On my ancestor's honor, I won't trouble sweet Carlotta again. Sure. What can I do for you? Ah, a fine but bloody tale. I can do that one. This is a local favorite and one of the first songs I ever learned. Ragnar the Red.
Sadia, wake up.
Oh, there once was a hero.
Yes, Mom.
You want to just listen to the song briefly. Ah, okay.
Depends. Are you thirsty? Hungry?
Let's have a look. Built cream treat. Interesting. Now, one of the things about each of the inns got a specialized mead or wine that they actually produce here. So which is it that they actually are specialized in here? Not quite sure. Must be this one here. Black Brer Reserve. Restore 30 points of stamina. Stamina regeneration is 40% slower. Look at the price of that, though. Wow. That's quite a hefty one.
It's been a pleasure.
Thank you, my love. Sidia.
Then he went quiet in Ragnar the Red when he met the shield maiden Matilda, who said...
Let's have a brief look at this. Let me zoom out of the map. So, I'm zooming out. I'm trying to. Putting it on the world map now. As you can see, there is a Halted Stream camp over here, which is just north of where we are at the moment. So I guess that would be my next destination. Nope, I'm not going to place a marker there. I'm just going to basically bear that in mind. Oops, did I just steal something? It looks like I did. Let's sleep in a bed. I cannot sleep while guards are pursuing me. My apologies.
You have committed crimes against Skyrim and her people. What say you in your defense, smart man?
I was pretty sure I paid them off, but okay. Anyways, we're heading outside. Actually, would it be advantageous for me to travel to Silver Silent Moon Camp? It would, wouldn't it? So I'm actually going to fast travel there to save me the hassle of having to do that outside. And we're on our way to the next camp. Which, if I'm not mistaken, is in this direction here. Actually, it's further to the left. Which is fine. It's running away from something, it looks like. Butterflies. Where's the butterfly? I thought I saw the butterfly there. There they are. Alright, two butterflies were captured. Or taken. Is he running away from me? That's interesting. Hello, Wolfie. Are you afraid of me now? Let's have a look at our quick list and let's actually pick up one of those potions. No, let's see if I can actually get that. Cool, I should have now basically filled one of these soul gems. As you can see that little aura around me, that's typically an indicator you filled the soul gem. So that's good. That's what's kind of my reasoning for doing what I just done. As you can see, there's an elk lying here. That probably was killed by the wolves. More flowers over here, and there is a river here. So let's have a look by the river. Am I overburdened? I am. That's why I'm actually walking slowly at the moment. Because I forgot to do one key thing. When I actually was in town, I should have actually sold off some of the stuff I got on me. So I need to head back to town in a second. What is it that I got on me that I can actually get rid of? Let's have a look at some of the food. Flour sack. If I look, eat up the venison. And maybe drop one of the sacks here. Perfect. As you can see, I can move quickly again. Pick up some of these flowers here. And what I'm actually doing, I will actually see if I can sneak up to them. Which I very much doubt is going to happen. So the one thing I just want to do here briefly is I want to basically just get that marker on my map. Once I got the marker on my map, I should be able to just ride off again into the sunset. Head back to Whiterun. Enemies are nearby, so I'm not able to do that at the moment. So let's do this differently. Let's just see if I can run further away from here. Get rid of the enemies. I don't want to take them on at the moment, just because I want to basically get rid of my excess gear. I want to clear up some of the inventory I've got at the moment. What is this? This looks like a graveyard. Poachers. Probably should have tried to use my illusionary magic, but okay. Arrows, gold, picklocks, fur, hide, carrot, okay. There's a mammoth here, which can give me a mammoth snout. But that kind of gives me the issue again of having too much stuff on me. Now, to some extent I can deal with that. I can actually, in a second, get rid of some of the stuff I got on me. Now, if I got a potion of strength, I might be able to overcome this. Potion of strength is what I'm looking for. And no, I don't have any of that. So let's have a look at the ingredients that we got. Have I got any ingredients that I actually haven't tested yet? Farringer frost salt. Look at the price of that, though. Farringer's frost salt. I'm going to keep that as is for the moment being. So moths, skeevers, small antlers. I haven't done those before. As you can see at the moment, I'm basically overburdened at present. Now, if there was basically a bunch of poachers over here, might very well mean that there will be other bits here as well, other than that. What is that aura around me? Ah, probably because I used... Let's hope it is. If I look at the active effects... So the small antler is giving me the weakness to poison. I still have the Mage Stone active, which is good. It looks like I will have to basically get rid of some of the stuff I'm carrying. Because at the moment I'm in no state at all to run or anything of that sort. What is this on this stone here though? I haven't seen that before. Interesting. Interesting, interesting. Anything else of interest here? It's not fun walking around at this space, as you can notice. So let's just dump some of the actual apparel that I've got on me that I don't necessarily need. I can actually get rid of the iron stuff, iron armor. So let's drop that first off. Then I've still got an overcarrying capacity of 28. So let's get rid of the steel armor as well. Brings me back into the appropriate range, and now I should be able to, of course, travel down to Whiterun. Alright, back in here. I'm gonna talk to this lady here.
You're someone who can get got some good pieces out here if you're looking to buy. More
what have you got for sale? Yes. You got sufficient money, which is good, which is exactly what I'm looking for. Sell some of these bows here. There's bow of binding, which I don't need myself. Iron greatsword, iron sword, iron war axe of dismay. Okay, that is worth 55 only. Pity. Bow of binding, 126. In terms of apparel, I've got a fair amount of stuff here I can actually sell off. Light shield, imperial light boots, iron helmet, right one's guard, helmet. Now I'm actually going to keep that shield, helmet and guard here. I'd love to be able to put them in some kind of inventory or storage chest, which I just don't have as of yet. I can in the meantime, of course, sell that deer hide. I can sell the wolf pelt. I could sell the silver ingot. I'm going to keep the orichalcum ingot because those are relatively rare. Now I'm going to go to one of the other shops in town to sell further gear. So again, before you go out into the wilds, make sure you actually clear up your inventory as much as you can. Right. Speaking to this guy here.
Everything's for sale, man. Some may call this junk. Me, I call
it. Right, I'm gonna sell on the scales, which are relatively expensive. I'm also gonna sell on the bones, which are relatively expensive. I am then also gonna sell them other stuff. Let's see what else I can sell them. Iron daggers. Not sure why I didn't sell that to the previous merchant, but that's okay. Imperial light boots. Do I want to sell them? I'm going to keep them for the moment, I think. Minor magic, huh? Speech increased to 22. And I've actually just leveled, which is great. Any other items I want to sell here? I don't think so. I actually want to enchant some of that stuff first. Let's see what he's got, though, to sell me. I'm looking for soul gems that are empty at the moment. The soul gems, lesser soul gem. Again, not very, very expensive at the moment to buy. But of course they will increase in value as I fill them up. Alright, I've got 139 in terms of what I can carry. Now, I did basically finish a quest here for one of those ladies here. Was it this young lady here? Once I've made enough money trading with nope, it was the other lady there. I'm going to buy the banner mare from Hilda. Life's hard enough. Really? I thank the gods, but I'll settle for that. Alright, so I gained 250, and I only spent 105 to be able to do so. That's a pretty good deal, I'd say. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to that site that we wanted to travel to earlier. And in here, I want to basically use some of my abilities here. Let's just verify what particular spell it is. Spell 1 is Fury. Look at that, they're fighting each other. I wouldn't leave her alive. Well, I think I will. Thank you very much, though. Alright, an ale, garnet. Let's pick up all the other items that are actually worth something here. Okay. Get another bandit died by my hands. By my hands or each other's hands, it doesn't really matter. They're dead, that's the key thing. Iron arrows, steel arrows. There is a longbow, there's gold, studded armor, fur bracers, etc., etc. And then this gentleman here had, of course, some other stuff on him. Wisp wrappings, necromancer robes. Interesting, necromancer robes again. And of course there was a dead guy over there as well. Cool. I could of course just close the gate. It won't make much of a difference here at all, but yeah, still. That's a couple of sacks. I don't want to do anything with that at the moment. So what else? What a look at what else we got here. A woodcutter's axe. Woodcutter's axe. A grindstone. Mammoth snout. Tanning rack. There's some leeks down here. Some more plants down here as well. Let's take all of those. I'm pretty sure there was here a chest. As you look over here, yes, you will see there is a chest. Let's see if we can disarm that trap. We were able to basically get rid of the chest, the trap on there, which is good. Perfect. There is another potion here. Two potions to be precise. There's a barrel that I can search. Of course, there's more flowers down here. And I'm pretty sure there was another chest here somewhere. Ah, down there. Of course, we're going to keep on losing these until we open it. Iron armor, gold, soul gem, scroll of guardian circle. I'm gonna leave the iron armor in there, I think. Anything else here that's of interest? I don't think so. I need a woodcutter's axe to be able to do anything there. What does that allow me to do? It allows me to basically chop some wood. Nice animation anyways. Firewood. I don't need firewood, so I'm actually gonna stop that. Not gonna basically do anything with the firewood here. Gonna try to sneak on the inside there. Now do bear in mind, this place is littered with traps. At least I think it is littered with traps. Oops, as you can see, I just triggered one of the traps there by accident. There was a pressure plate here, which I just stepped on top of. There's a vein here, which I can actually, of course, mine. I like the animation, though. No matter what it is you're wearing in terms of armor or outfit, it'll still do the animation and it actually shows you what's going on there. Let's have a brief look. Can I maybe use the comm facility on that guy? I could try. Tusks. Those are quite expensive.
Need something? Yes.
Seconds, I believe it was. Hopefully, that gives me enough time to actually mine this iron ore. Sorry, young lady. If you don't want to listen to me, I'll have to deal with you differently. Oh well. Healing up. Maintaining your health is quite important here, of course. Key to Halted Steam Mine, which is good. Helmet is always good to value to weight ratio. The rest I'm just going to let be here. As you saw me doing earlier, I was actually mining this iron ore vein. I'm going to carry on doing so, trying to get the last bits of iron ore from there. More iron ore. And there is another bit of ore behind me as well, it looks like. More iron ore. Now it looks like there's actually red patterns in there, which actually be garnets, I think. Let's have a look at what that actually gives me in a second. Will it be garnets or will it be other stones? Oh. Alright, we depleted the vein here. More iron ore. It can be a bit boring looking at all these iron ore mining, but let's just get it done. calm was quite effective. But I'm actually going to move it back to the fury. Hopefully I'll be able to use that to let them kill each other. Now what have we got here? More iron ore, of course. Open the skills menu to level up. Yes, okay, I guess I'll do that shortly. Perfect. Another vein has been depleted, and there's more iron ore here. Gosh, by the end of this particular mine, I'll actually be littered with iron ore. So you see the iron ore on the floor here, but also on the wall. And as you actually deplete one of the veins, you should see that the coloring itself will change drastically. And now I can actually mine the wall separately from the floor. Flawless garnet. And as you see, I did say there would be a garnet in the iron ore. It's those little red sparks that you saw in there. Anything else? There's more iron ore. Wow. Question, of course, then would be, well, how many iron ore do we expect to be able to get from here? Alright. Now, be careful with these bones. Those are kind of like an alarm signal here. As you'll see with the electricity, it'll actually eat into your yeah, he's hitting me, but I just barely ran out of mana there. Luckily, I was able to take him down before he took me down. That was a close call, though. So next time, I need to keep a closer eye on actually what's happening to my health. And now I can, of course, go and collect the bounty for this guy. My restoration has increased, which is good. Steel dagger is always good value as well in terms of weight or value to weight ratio. Orcish Warhammer is about a ratio of 1 to 8, I would say. No, 1 to 7. Not the best, but it's not the worst either. Let's have a look down here. Bandit, mana potion. Alright, let's leave that behind. And this guy here, again, let's search him as well. Poacher's axe, amethyst, gold, block with meat, armor, and hide boots. There will be a whole raft of stuff that we can actually pick up from here. Loot. There is a book on the history of the region. Now, do bear in mind, there is oil lying down here, so you need to be extremely careful with that. The mammoth tusks are an amazing value for weight again. Luckily, we do find numerous of them over here. There's another mammoth here, which has got a snout. And again, there's lots of drinks of many sorts, whether that's potions and so forth, lying here as well. Coin purse. There is a transmutation mineral ore here, which is a great spell to have. Disaster of Lonith. Right, now let's have a look at what we actually are carrying at the moment in terms of miscellaneous items. Anything I can drop in here? Tusks I'm not going to drop. Ingredients. How overweight am I? Have I got any particular potions now that allow me to carry more? Not that I can see. Stamina, no. I need strength, really. Okay, weapons. Hunter's bow I can easily drop, which is relatively poor value anyways. The pickaxe I could drop as well. Let's drop the axe. I don't need that one. Okay. Iron ore. There is a silver ore here as well. And of course we got our good chest here. Iron battle axe, which is not really what I'm looking for. That's a good value. Garnet and gold. Alright, what else have we got here? Again, I'm overweight, so let's have a little look at what we can actually drop. Pickaxe I can easily drop here as well. Too much. Let's have a look in the dresser itself. Hat, no. Clothes, no. There is books here that I want to take. The cake and the diamond. Ultimately, I want to build up my own little book collection, so having these books at my disposal really, really helps in that particular regard. Right, I'm overweight again. Now, there's still a section in here, well, behind that section here, where I want to basically have a look at what they got lying around there. Ooh, another coin purse. It's quite a bit to this section here. Always check out all the little nooks and crannies again. As you can see, there's another chest here, which I thought was trapped, but I'm not entirely sure. We go, open it as well. Lots of gold in there again. Pick locks has increased. Actually, was it stamina that increased the carry capacity or not? Was it strength? Let's have a brief look. Tab. Let's level up. It's actually stamina, so if I'm able to increase my stamina in a minute for a short duration, that will help. I'm going to increase my magicka again. Now I've got 1 point to spend. I want to basically do this on illusion, I think. Have I spent anything on illusion already? Yes, I have. I don't want to do the dual casting for that one. Animage. Higher level animals. Apprentice illusion. Requires 25, which is nice. Takes me to adapt, expert, and ultimately master. All spells you cast from any school of magic are silent to others. Interesting. Now, I did say I wanted to basically specialize in illusion, didn't I? So, taking that into account, let's go for the apprentice illusion here. Do I want to? Yeah, let's. That means that my spells in the future will cost me less. Don't need to heal myself up as much as you see over here. Now there's another vein here, there is another trap there. I don't have any longer the pickaxe on me, so I won't be able to do the mining of this. As you can see, there's another trap above me. I did have potions of stamina, didn't I? Actually, it doesn't increase my carrying capacity, unfortunately. I thought it would, but it doesn't, as you can see. Right. That is a bit of a pity here, this location, because, yeah, as you can see, there is a high elf in here. Who's got nice clothing. a hat and so forth. There's a coin purse there. There's a deer here. Need to be extremely careful here, because what else have we got there? Is there just the one coin purse? Yeah, it looks like it. But being out here, I should, in theory, be able to do the quick travel. Now, I don't have enough carrying capacity at the moment. I need to drop some of the stuff I picked up here. Question is, which items am I going to drop? Wait. So one of these. And one of these is, in theory, sufficient, which is good, because I'm going to go straight to Whiterun. I'm over encumbered still. Okay, so let's have another look at the apparel I've got on me. Oops, not my intention. I had meant to basically stay equipped with the Talmorian stuff. Perfect. Now I am able to quick travel. At this point, of course, I am able to quick travel, and I'm basically able to sell my stuff here. Is she still able to talk to me and able to trade with me? That's the question.
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith in Whiterun. Yorland Greymane's got that.
Okay. I'm not going to break into there. Forget about that.
Have you met my father? He's a steward at the Dragon's Reach.
Need a blade? You should talk to Adrian.
Again, I'm not going to break into there either. Let's quickly turn in the quest at the Jarl, and after I turn on the quest at the Jarls. That's a nice comment.
If you're heading east,
once I've made enough money, trade. Thank you. This should turn that old gate.
Good.
As promised, let me show you a thing or two about bargaining. Don't want some shifty merchant giving you a raw trade.
Cool.
Farewell.
Increased my speech.
Damn those great names to Oblivion. They want to back the storm
close. So whenever they're referring to Oblivion, just bear in mind that's another realm in the Elder Scrolls series. So I guess it's their comparison towards Hell. Alright, that's my Thane. I am looking for the person who I can actually turn this quest back into. Who I was hoping is up here, but it looks like he's not. Let's look at the great porch here. See if we can find him up here. No, it looks like I might be better served to wait until the morning. Unless I want to really go through all of the rooms here.
Fear not. The dragon or giant will be ready.
Alright, maybe I'll just leave that for the next episode. Anyways, thanks again for joining me. Hopefully you did enjoy it. And yeah, if so, just if you'd leave a comment down below, that'd be great. And I will see you on the next one. Have a good day. Bye-bye.